The Scribble Press app is a fantastic app for children to make their own stories on the iPad and then save them as ebooks. So you get three options when you open: your books, your drawings, or your gallery. So we're going to make a book. So if you click on New Book, there's a couple of ways you can do it. You can actually just do a completely blank book where you draw your own pictures, insert your own text, or you can choose some of their preset books. So if we have a look at Family, for example, you can do a book all about my dad, and it will actually give you a set format that you can just fill in some words. So this is a book about my dad. My dad's name is, let's call him John. Okay, and when you've finished all of those fill-in sections, it will actually then make it into a book for you. So I'll just fill the rest out and then we'll make the book. So I've filled out all of those fields, and now if we click Create My Book, it will actually open up the book and it automatically puts the text in there for you. You can click through the pages. Okay, so it's got all the text there. It's a 6-page book at the moment, and we can now add images, pictures, text, and various other things to those pages. So the first thing we need to do is insert a picture or draw a picture. Drawing's quite simple. You choose a pen along the bottom and you can draw whatever you like. So we can put in tree. You can color things in as well. Also, you may want to insert a pre-made animation. So there's a selection here, a selection of stickers you can put in. So I'm going to find something that hopefully looks like my dad. There you go. And when you insert the figure, before you press on the green tick, you move the picture to wherever you'd like this. So move him over there and click tick. Let's also put in, you can put in photos from your camera roll, so you can either take a photo or choose an existing photo. So that's quite good for dropping pictures in. You've also got an eraser, so we can rub out some of the sections. We've got a text tool, so I can actually insert some more text. And you can, as normal, you can click and preview, go back and change some of the other text. So if you only like parts of the format that they've given you, you only have to use parts of it. There's some stamp tools. So this one's a cloud stamp. We can actually put some clouds up in the sky. And there's a massive range of other colors and options you can do. So if we click on this sort of pencil shelf, it gives you a range of colors. And if we click on a particular color, it then gives you a pop-up menu with different stamp tools, so different shapes and faces there, and also a few different types of pen. So if we click on one of those stamp types, it'll add it to your toolbar down the bottom. And if we click back on the picture, we can now choose that stamp and we can go and put in some stars. So there's some good flexibility there with drawing pictures for your book. To add another page to a book, when you arrow your way through to the last page, so this is page 6 of 6, there's an icon that comes up that allows you just to add a page. And then if you want to put in your own text, press the text tool. Show you that again, just the T there, and you can enter whatever you like. Make your own text for your book. The last thing, if you have a lot of icons across the bottom, like say you go to the shelf and you pick a lot of different tools to add to your bookshelf, they'll keep adding across the bottom. So what you can then do, you can actually drag the bottom toolbar to the left and to the right. So the other option that we have on there, when we drag it to the left, you can actually change the background color. So it gives you a range of background colors to choose from. So I'm going to change the background to the green color. We can also adjust the cover of our book. So at the moment we're on the Pages tab, but if you click on the next one, that gives you the front page and back page. So if you click on the title, you can edit that with your keyboard. You can also edit the illustrator author details down the bottom. And if you want to choose a different picture for your cover picture, click on the picture and it takes you to all your pages that you've drawn. So you can choose a different piece of art. I haven't got any other pieces of art at the moment, but we could choose a different one. So that's quite a good feature as well. That's the front cover. If we click on the back button, it takes us to the back cover. So you can put in a photo of yourself as the author. And you can put in a bit of information about that book. We'll just go back to the pages view. There is a redo and an undo button. So let's say I want to undo that. Now I want to redo that. So that's another good feature. Once you've finished your book, you can then just click I'm finished. And it will make your book for you and give you the sharing options. So now if we go back and look at our bookshelf, We should have my books, and there's the book I've just made, all about my dad. If I wanted to edit that again, click on the book, you get back to these options, click on edit, and it takes you back to where you were before. If you actually go to the gallery section, you can download books that other people have made and uploaded to Scribble Press, and one of them that you can get from the most popular section is a book on how to make a Scribble Press book. So I previously downloaded this one, How to Make a Book, and if you go back to my collection, you'll see it is in there, How to Make a Book, and it actually just takes you through how to make a Scribble Press book. So to move pages, you just drag from the left or right of the screen to view your book. So once you've made your book, if you want to send to iBooks or share it, you'll need to make a Scribble Press account. So if you click on either of those, so I actually need to create an account. Let's click on that. It takes me to this screen. I need to enter an email address, password, and a username. Click continue. Agree to the terms and conditions, and it's making my account. So once that's done, now if I click send to iBooks, it'll prepare to upload, converts it to an EPUB format, and then gives you the option to open in a range of other apps. So we want it to open in iBooks. So if I click on that, now I didn't fill out all the pages, but this is the iBook. It's got the text. If we drag through, and we see the pictures we've put in. So it's fantastic. Students can make their own books. Send them to their iPad and then show them to the class through the projector maybe with the VGA adapter. Wonderful idea. So they could publish their book on the Scribble Press gallery, share via Facebook, Twitter, email a link. Once again, you can open in iBooks. The last option, which is also quite exciting, you can order a copy of the book. So if you click on upload, you can ask for a copy of the book or make something else with the artwork from this book. So you can do a clipboard, puzzle, notepad, card. Upload your book. And then you get to this screen where you can say how many copies, all your order details, and your address anywhere in the world. So fantastic for kids to make their own books and then get a hard copy in the mail. Quite exciting.